Now I want to create a component for the sidebar for the left side of the screen. Okay, so if we go into VS Code and we go to Resources, JS, we can create a folder. Well, we'll do the folder on the file as well. So it'll be Components, and then the file name will just be Admin Sidebar dot view. Okay, and in here we'll just say HTML. We'll just say div sidebar, and then our script tags. Okay, so let's move that over. And then we are going to put this component now in our admin layout file. And now in this div right up here above the slat, okay, right above that div, we're going to add admin sidebar. Okay, and then we're going to go ahead and import it here. So import admin sidebar from at components admin sidebar, and then we'll just add that in our component section. So admin sidebar. So now if we go back to the browser and refresh, we should see that on the left side. Okay, great. So let's go ahead and start styling it up. So we'll head into the admin sidebar. And now we can get rid of this. And in this div, we can add a class of flex call, width full. And on small screens, we want it to have a width of 1/4. Okay, and in the div, we want another div with the class of BG white, overflow hidden, shadow XL. And on small sizes, we want rounded large. Okay, open that up. Now in here, we want a button. Okay, and I'm just going to paste these classes in here because it's a lot. Or it's not a lot, it's just more than I feel like typing right now. So button, we're going to have a span tag. And this is just going to say admins. So let's take a quick look and see what we have. We'll go back to the browser, refresh. Okay, great. But something's off because it should be centered and there should be a space. So let's check out our code. Check the admin layout. And this right here is supposed to have a colon. Okay, so let's go back and make sure that that's fixed. Go back, refresh. Okay, and now it has a much nicer layout. Let's head back into the code and continue on. We'll go back to the sidebar. And we are actually going to use two icons for the, if you go back to the browser, in this admins tab right here, we're going to have two little icons, one pointing to the left when it's closed and one pointing to the right when it's, or pointing down when it's open. So I'm just going to paste the first one here. And we'll create the functionality for it in a bit. And all this is just an icon up in the angle down. And then we're going to have another one here that I'm going to paste in. And this is going to be the angle left. Okay, if you watched my social network series, there's a video in it, and I'll link it down in the description for handling SVGs. If you're having a lot of SVGs or icons in your app, I have a good way of doing it in that social network series. Okay, let's take a look at the browser and make sure that those icons are coming in. Okay, so we have one facing down and one facing left. We'll fix those, like I said, in a bit. Let's just get this out of the way. So under this button tag, we're going to have another div, and it's going to be classes of flex and class flex call. Open those up. And we're going to create three inertia links. Okay, so inertia link. And for now, they won't be pointing anywhere. Equals, and we'll just put hashtag. Well, so copy, paste, paste. Okay, so the first one, we'll have a class of, well, we'll do this for all three. So we'll have a class text, write, capitalize, border, T for top, with the full PX 6 and PY of 2. Okay, so this one, this first one will just say admins. This next one will say roles. And this next one will say users. Okay, and then under this div, we're going to have another inertia link. And it's going to be href equals hashtag. And the class is going to be flex justify between items center border top px 6 py 2 and on hover we're gonna have a bg gray of 500 and then we're also gonna have a hover of text gray 50 and then in here just gonna say dashboard. Okay, and I should probably put a capitalize in there too. We'll put it on at the end of this. Okay, so let's take a look at our browser and see what we see. So go back, refresh, and okay, cool. So now we have our list and we'll make this open and close in a bit. So this hover we also want to get in here as well. Okay, so let's head back to the VS Code. And to set this up, what I want to do in here is create a data section. Okay, equals parentheses curly brackets. And then it's going to be open admins. And we'll set that to false. Okay, so when we click it, then it'll set it to true. Okay, so if we scroll up to the button, the open tag, we can put at click equals open admins. We'll say equals not open admins. Okay. And then on the first SVG that we have here, we can say vif open admins. And then on the next one, we'll just put vElse. And then if we scroll down to the next div, we'll say vif open admins. And we'll leave it at that. So we'll go back. We'll refresh. So now we have our menu here, and so if we hover and we click on it on the admins with the arrow, now we have these three new menu items, but we don't have these pages yet, which we'll get started on in the next episode. But we also have this one, which has the hover state as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead, leave it there. I'll make sure to push all this code up to GitHub. I'll leave the link down in the description. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.